Tom Weiss for you.
Impressions everyone encounters every day and all the various forms of media. It is in many ways, as some have said, the golden age of documentary movies, because it's almost the last place where one can sit in a communal environment and absorb a 90-minute presentation that is really very carefully crafted. And so I think that it is a premier. It's the queen of media these days. And I want to say that Bonnie Cohen and John Schenck, who are the directors of the movie you're about to see, are the ones who deserve the credit for it. I'm pretty biased, but I think they've done a terrific job. And I'm so excited that it's being premiered here in Zurich at the Zurich Film Festival. It's so exciting to be here.
About the presentation that we see a lot of in the second movie as well. I've read somewhere that you have 400,000 slides ready for your speeches, for your presentation. You know a lot about climate change. What are you, a man on a mission? Are you an eco-warrior? What drives you?
Well, I never expected this to become a mission. The word mission sounds like a very lofty concept, but it sort of became that. I had the great privilege in the 1960s of learning from one of the great climate scientists of all time, in some ways the father of climate science, Roger Revelle. By the way, Connie Stephan and Bianca Perrin and Thomas Stocker and Letizia Stocker are here. They are friends of mine who are in the Swiss climate science community and are among those that I have really learned from a great deal. But back when I was a college student in the 60s, I never imagined that this would become something that took over my life. 7 years after I graduated from college, I was elected to the US Congress, and I immediately asked, what's happening with global warming, climate change? And they didn't know what I was talking about, and nothing was happening. So I got permission from the chairman of one of my committees to organize the first congressional hearing in the 70s on the climate crisis. And I invited my professor to come and be the lead-off witness. And I was very naive in imagining that when my colleagues in the Congress heard this great scientist, that they would have the same epiphany that I had during a full college course, and of course it didn't happen. But that was the first time I began to think, how can this important truth that is so consequential for the whole future of the human race be communicated in a way that connects with people the way it connected with me? And that's really when I started trying to figure out a way to communicate what the scientists have been warning the world about for 50 years.
You've been working on that issue for 50 years. And let me just...
Not that long.
It seems long.
A little over 40 years.
But it's been a long way, let's put it that way. And without giving too much away, no spoilers here, but a big part of the film treats something that might have been the final success for your work. It's the Paris Climate Treaty that has been signed last year, and we cannot let you go without a political question in the end. We all know the United States have agreed to withdraw from that climate agreement from Paris. How does that make you feel? Angry, annoyed, frustrated? Give us the truth, it won't leave these four walls.
Even if it's inconvenient.
Exactly.
Well, after Donald, well, you'll see some of this in the movie, so I won't spoil it, but when he made his announcement that he was going to withdraw from the Paris Agreement, I was very worried that other countries would follow his lead and that would be a very negative event. But I was very, very happy when the next day, every other country, and Turkey's made some weird noises, I think they're gonna stay in also, but with that one partial exception, every other country in the world said the next day, so Donald Trump, okay, we're still in the Paris Agreement. And then in the US, our largest state governments, hundreds of cities, business leaders, all said, we're still in the Paris Agreement. There are two hashtags popular in the US now. One is hashtag, we're still in. And the evidence now demonstrates pretty clearly that with current trends, the US is going to meet and in fact exceed the commitments it made in the Paris Agreement, regardless of Donald Trump. The other hashtag is hashtag, we got this. And it is not that Donald Trump is irrelevant to this now, he's not, but he has isolated himself. And the goals and commitments of the Paris Agreement are now embedded in business, industry, with investors, with cities and states, as I mentioned, with NGOs and civil society. We're moving forward. We're in the early stages of a sustainability of the digital revolution. Switzerland is helping to lead the way, by the way. Thank you very much. The voters of Switzerland and the government of Switzerland. But where my country is concerned, I would just ask you to please make a clear distinction between Donald J. Trump and the United States of America.
Let's go and see the movie. Would you give us the honor to the introduction?
I hope you really get a lot out of this movie. I have one request. If you do feel, after experiencing this movie, that it is a worthwhile experience, and that it is an experience that you would like others to have, please encourage others to see it. Because, again, in the busy media environment of today, nothing is so powerful as the recommendation of a respected friend. And again, it is up to you, depending on your reaction to this movie. I'm very heartened at the reaction so far, but if you do have a positive reaction, please recommend it to others. The more people who see it, the more momentum we have a chance to build in the climate community. And as I said at another event earlier this evening, I mean this very, sincerely, anyone who doubts that we, the human species, have the political will to solve this crisis should never forget that political will is itself a renewable resource. Thank you very much. Don Kuchin.
être en eux qui souhaitent écouter l'information. Je vais le leur dire.